All right, so welcome back, and let's talk about Arduino tutorials. In the last video, we introduced Arduino and Arduino board, and now we are ready to do the tutorials. Now, of course, this tutorial, it was designed to be for hands-on with actual Arduinos. But obviously, for obvious reasons, this is difficult to achieve today. So we're going to work with the next best thing. Now, of course, if you are able to find or to buy your own Arduino set at home, and then do the actual tutorials hands-on, then I would definitely recommend that option. If you don't, then you're going to lose out greatly on learning. Now, in our module, we already put the list of hardware that is available in the box. You can then go and buy them. And by the way, I would strongly suggest that you do this not only for the Arduino, but as well as for the Raspberry Pi. Unfortunately, in Arduino, we do have a sort of an alternative to do Arduino in online or in simulation, but for Raspberry Pi, there isn't. So you may have to work with an actual Raspberry Pi. So I would strongly suggest that you go and try and buy your own training kit or secure kit. Maybe at least for now, you should get the Arduino board as well, or at least. And let's hope that this MCO will end soon so we can get back to our lab. Now, why is it important to work hands-on? So let's see that. First of all, I want to show you where can we do simulation or Arduino tutorial hands-on. Well, basically, all you have to do is go online to Tinkercad, or in other words, Tinkercad. tinkercad.com, and let's go. So this is tinkercad.com, and I'm going to join right now. Actually, I do have an account, but in your case, you'll have to register. Very easy to register. It's for free. All you need is an email or use your own social media. Essentially, I already have an own account, so I'm gonna register with my Facebook and give it some time to load. And so as soon as you log in, you're going to come to the dashboard area, which is loading now. And if you're wondering why it took so long to load, now we are here now because this is my account and I registered before. But when you log in for the first time, you're going to see something different. No? Okay. So essentially, you will see options, 3D design, circuits, code blocks, and lessons. Of course, if you want, you can go for lessons. There's other trainings and other topics, as well as 3D design. Actually, Tinkercad is done by Autodesk, which is the creators of CAD or AutoCAD. So this is considered a nice place to learn online, not just Arduino, but other things as well. But for our purposes today, I need you to click on circuits. And as you can see, it is actually meant specifically for Arduino. So you go and click on circuits, or you can click on create new circuits. It's either one is fine. So click on those after you register, and you come and you find circuits, and you come, and then it will open up the simulation area. Now it's taking its time to load is because it's a lot of visuals here, so it's going to take some time to load. And also because the internet nowadays is being overused, so the quality, the bandwidth of the video is being utilized extensively by everyone now. So let this load for a while. Now, while we are waiting for this to load, let's get back to the slide. And the last time I had to wait for something to load like this, it was in the 90s. So this. And my internet is very fast. Anyway, so let's get back to the slide and talk about this for a minute. Why is it important for you to work on hardware, on an actual Arduino, not on a simulation? You see, when you work with an actual Arduino, you will learn, or you're gonna go through all of these three problems: the actual hardware setup, the interaction problem, as well as the programming. When you're going to work on Tinkercad or in the simulation, you are not going to have these two problems. the hardware issue and the interaction issues will be resolved because everything is going to be simulated. And on top of that, although we're going to do programming, but it will not be in the Arduino IDE. It will be in another IDE altogether. So the program is exactly the same, but the environment is slightly different because there is no actual hardware there. So although you're going to be learning, the only thing that you're going to be learning to work with is the programming as well as the interaction. Yes, you will build a circuit on simulation, but that is actually a simulated circuit. So some of the stuff that happens in real life, you won't experience here. And also this issue right here, linking the Arduino to the PC, that is not going to be there at all. So working in Tinkercad is useful, definitely for beginners, is very useful. Maybe it's useful for those who are learning for the first time because it eliminates some of these headaches. But then I would suggest that you do it on Tinkercad first, or at least in the beginning, and then you will have to work on an actual Arduino board, because working on Tinkercad alone is not enough. Now, if you're working with Arduino for the first time, facing all these three problems at the same time will be a challenge for you, because if you're a beginner. So perhaps Tinkercad is a good way to start, but definitely not enough. So let's see what happened there. It looks like it's done. Okay, so that's good. So that's essentially, you know what, I'm gonna even remove this. So when you go to this, you're gonna see that. So what do you, this is the area where we're gonna build our work. Now even this, by the way, oh wait, this is that, okay. So I'm gonna delete this, and I'm going to delete this. You're about to delete one of the more program, yes, okay, no problem. So essentially, this is the blank area that we're gonna be working here, we're gonna building our stuff. Now, how do you change this? You can actually come and put all, and in fact, if you come here and put Arduino, you're gonna see that you have a basically a pre-built Arduino systems. Some of them are ready to go. All you have to do is just click on one of these. Here's the Plink program, and then click on it, and then roll the mouse, and then click again, and here we are. And then it's already built and everything. Then you can go and actually take a look at the program is right there. Now, when you click on code, you're gonna see that this, now this actually is called blocks, but we didn't work with blocks, we're gonna work with text only. Continue. So this is now the familiar program that you saw before. If you remember when we worked with the Arduino IDE in the previous video, you have setup and loop, is that right? Well, this is setup and this is loop, so it's exactly the same thing. In fact, it's already programmed right here. And by the way, this is very similar to our Arduino tutorial one. So essentially, if you look at it and you can click on start simulation, it will be connected and powered on. And then the program will start and it's going to blink. So this is essentially a completely done tutorial. You know what I mean? And you can click on code to remove it and close it. You can also change whether you like, you cannot actually change the type of program while it's running. You have to stop the simulation and only then you can select yes. So these are both now here. If you would like to learn what blocks is, essentially, it's a great way to do it. Blocks is a visual way of programming Arduino. I personally prefer coding because I learned C before and it's easier to work with coding for me. If you prefer to work with blocks, it's fine with me. If you'd like to learn, so you can use this option. I would suggest that you work with coding because blocks are useful for those who don't want to do programming. But then blocks are not useful if you're working with libraries and stuff. Because some of these libraries, they may not have alternative or options for coding. Okay, so let's close this. Okay, how do I get rid of all of this? So you can just undo or cancel, delete. You can rotate things around here, roll out. So once again, you can just delete options from here. Yes, delete this, select the resistor and LED. And now we're gonna basically go back to basic. And then we're gonna build our circuit from scratch. So here's our tutorial. We're gonna go now to tutorial number one and implement it. Earlier, by the way, I mentioned or showed that we have these libraries. We'll see those in action. But basically, what's going on? Let's just do that in a minute. So here's our first tutorial. Our objective is to build what is called a blinking LED. Actually, we're going to repeat the function we saw earlier. Essentially, what we need is the Arduino, one LED, and then resistor, and then this circuit right here. And it's very important that we read the instructions. Equipment is right here. Now, of course, if we were working in a lab, we will have to pick these items from the box, and then we will have to follow these instructions to connect it onto the board. So the LED, which is has the long leg, the LED actually may not be visible here, but I'll show you later, has, let's do that right now. So here's the LED. Maybe we cannot see it right now, but actually this curve right here is actually the shorter one, and this one is the longer one. You can see cathode and anode. So these are the positive and negative. And you can see the curve is right here. So the positive one will be on the curve leg or the short leg or the anode, and then the cathode will be the negative. Then we're going to have to put the 1 ohm resistor here. And remember the instructions about never ever connecting the LED directly without the resistor. And then we'll have to put 13 and ground. So essentially 13, but the idea is that we're going to write a small program that is going to tell the LED to blink. So obviously this is going to be an output. So this is going to go out to the LED, and then before it gets back to the board, we're going to go through the resistor to shorten the amount of power or whatever, right? Or reduce the voltage or the amperage, and then it will go back through to the ground. So once again, remember what we talked about before about, about the rules of the breadboard. First of all, these horizontal lines are not connected, but these vertical lines are connected. So this wire and this leg are connected, and this leg and this resistor are connected. These two are not connected, but these guys are connected. And then from here, we go to the ground. Now, of course, if you might be thinking, so this is too easy. Why do we even need a breadboard? You're right, but then we're going to start with a breadboard, and we're going to actually continue to work with it for consistency. So let's go ahead to Tinkercad and build this circuit. So what do we need, of course, before we get to this? We need an Arduino. So click on it, drag, and it will be here. And then we need a breadboard. You can always zoom out if you wish. And we're gonna need an LED. By the way, if you'd like to change color, you can do that later. So first come here, and you can actually change to the color that you like. I like blue, so that's it. And you can give it a name. For now, I'll just give it a name, number 4, whatever. Okay, then what? We need obviously a resistor. And again, you can choose the how many ohms you want. So right now, this is 1 kilo ohm. If you'd like more, you can actually change it. There's several ways. This is kilo ohm, ohm, micro, milli, micro, nano, and whatever that is, mega, giga, and kilo. We're gonna stick with kilo, and we're gonna stick with 1, and this is the number. What else? And after that, we what else is there? Okay. Alt tab. Nope, not this one. Yeah, here. Where's my Tinkercad? Nope. Here and here. Okay, so we have LED, resistor, and then 2 wires. So let's do it. So I'm gonna zoom in a little bit. So pick a place. Don't worry, these two are not connected, but I would like to turn this. So here's the object to turn. So here's the button, so turn it, turn, turn, turn. Oh, no. Okay. It doesn't matter which one is right or left, it just can be all connected like this. Oh, this is too short, so I'm gonna have to move this a little bit. So now we're good to go. Now, what are we gonna, oh, this is lovely. This is actually visualizing the connection. You can see how these are all connected, but same thing here. But this guy, these are all connected. Oh, this is lovely. Just go and see it. Oops. Oh, this is a wire. I'll just cancel that. I wanna see all in one shot. Okay, so this right here is lovely because if you actually come here and you can see that it highlights to you that these are all connected. These are all 4 green dots are connected. And same thing here. Notice that how these 3 green dots are not connected to these 4 here. But all of these horizontal lines are connected and all of these are connected and so on. Okay, so now we build the components. What's next? Well, what's next is that we need to connect them with wires. So we simply bring the mouse and click on this red dot right here and then drag the mouse. Of course, I can just do this, but this is ugly. So instead, what we're going to do, we're going to first of all cancel. We're going to actually use corners. So click on this, move the mouse, click one time, and then you create an angle. And one more, and then you come to 13. Now, if you'd like to move that later, it's fine. Is it 13? I forgot. So here goes to 13, yes. And the other one goes to ground. So start from here, and then click, and move again, and to ground. Now, by default, it's all green, but you can change the color to black. We're good to go, or whatever color you like. So now we have actually, let's compare the circuit between, okay, black is too dark, you cannot see the thing. So let's go to red. Okay, so now let's zoom in and confirm. So LED short leg goes to port number 13, and then resistor connected to this guy, and it's also connected here, it goes to ground. Let's confirm that. Yes, 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 and we're good to go. So now what's next we need to do is to program it to do our blinking. Now, how does that work? Oh, we don't need any hardware, so we can close this again now. So so now, how do we actually program this system? So first, we go to the program. I don't want blocks. I want text. Yes. Oh, it's already there. I think it was from the previous word. Okay, so let's take a look at what's going on here. First of all, in the pin setup, you need to tell, remember hardware abstraction when we talked about it before? This is basically hardware abstraction right here, or the driver. This is a library or a function that is written already in Arduino library. You'll have to, using pin mode function, you are declaring two things. First of all, the number of pin you're gonna be working with. If you remember, we said that this LED is gonna be linked to pin number 13, is that right? Well, that's what's going on here. Next, we are also going to tell the program that this is an output, meaning the information or the output is going to go that way, from the board to the LED. So that's an output. If this was a sensor, so therefore the data would come from the sensor to the board, so that would be an input. But since we are giving it instruction out from the board into the LED, so that would be called an output. And we are actually declaring that here. So now, pin mode 13 output. What we are saying here really is we are basically saying that this pin, this is a comment by the way, this pin 13 is an output. Is an output pin. This is very important because knowing whether it's an output or an input will actually tell us other things later on. So this is the setup. Okay, and then what's next? Well, what's next is the actual work that we're going to do with this program. So how do you make the LED blink? Well, first of all, how do you make it on? How do you switch it on? See, when you actually start, right now it's switched off. So how do you switch it on? Well, that's actually easy. All you have to do is write this code right here, or this function right here. Digital write means, essentially digital write means it's a function from Arduino that says, I have instructions, do this. So write means giving information or giving commands out. Okay, what do you want? So first of all, I want to give this instruction to pin number 13. Okay, what do you want? Well, I want it to be high. High means switched on. So basically what you are telling right now, go to pin number 13 and make it into the condition high. High here coming from logic gates. High means switched on or true. You could write true, false, one, and these are all mean the same thing, means switch on. And a semicolon, obviously, because it's a C++ program. So when you write this program, it will switch on. Okay, then what's next? Well, after that, what's going to happen is that the next line is we are telling the program to delay for about 1 second. When we wrote C++ last time, we actually had the time and then sleep. Remember that? Time.sleep? Well, in Arduino, they simplify this for us. We don't have to use the time library. We just use directly delay. And this is delay for 1,000 milliseconds. So 1,000 milliseconds equals to how many seconds? 1 second. So basically this will, so this will be switched on, then wait for a second, and then what happens? Then digital write again to the same pin, and then low. Low means switch it off. And basically it was switched on, then switch off, then delay, sorry, switch on, then delay for 1 second, then switch off, and then delay for 1 second, and then repeat. Remember the loop? Repeat forever. So on off is actually, essentially, this is the blinking effect. That's how you can actually create the blinking effect, by simply switching it on and off and then looping through it effectively. Well, let's see it. So zoom out a little bit. Now keep an eye here, or let's just zoom in a little bit. Yeah, so start simulation. Now it's powered on. Take a look at what's going on here. It's on, off, and so on. Now let us tweak the program a little bit. I don't like, it's too slow for my liking. So let's make this faster a little bit by making it half a second. Okay, so close. Oh, by the way, it's a habit. When you write a program, I usually Control S to save the program. You don't have to do that here. It's automatically saved. So close, run the program. It should blink faster now. Tech, tech. If you're still not fast enough to your liking, you can make this even faster. So by making it 1/10 of a second, I'm not sure how good or bad that will be. Let's see. Yep, it's blinking faster. Now, what happens if you make it zero? If, let's say, I comment out the weight altogether, what happens? Now, before I show you what happens, you need to ask yourself what happens. This is a good exercise in programming in general, that before you do something, try to ask yourself, try to predict what is going to happen, how the program is going to respond, using only logic and common sense. Then if the program behaves the same way you predicted it, that means you're good. That means you are, your logic or common sense in programming is working. So right now, I know what's going to happen. So this is going to be a cheat, but I want you to think about it for a minute and see what's going to happen. If you might think, oh, this is fast, this is low, so what will happen? Okay, figure it out. You can pause if you want to try to think about it for a second. Okay, let's see it. Keep an eye here. Well, what's going on? It's always on. And you might be thinking, sir, it's not blinking. Actually, it is blinking. But because there is no delay here, it's blinking too fast. We cannot notice it with our naked eye. The delay here is important because it allows you to see it. It's basically on and off. It's too fast for us to notice it. So that's why the delay was always there. Maybe 300. Yeah, 300 is a good enough number. And then start the simulation, hide the code, and you'll see the blinking happening again. And that's it. This is tutorial number one, which is essentially the blinking LED. Although it's too easy, but you learned a lot of concepts here about Arduino. Essentially, you learned about setup, pin mode, as well as digital write and digital write again, as well as the importance of the sleep function. By the way, the capital letter here, as well as here, these are not coincidence. These are actually on purpose. And you'll have to ensure that when you're writing the program, essentially, that you'll have to follow exactly not only the spelling, but also the sense or the capital sense. Okay. All right. So with this, we finish our first tutorial, and then we are done with this program. So I'll see you in the next video when we do the next tutorial.